everybody. At the onset, I request you all to kindly put your mobiles on silent mode. It is our honor and pleasure and privilege to welcome Dr. Abdul Kalam, the former President of India. To introduce him would be to belittle him, as he needs no introduction. So I leave it at that. He's an icon by himself, and I think we would devote more time in interacting with him. It is also my pleasure to welcome Right Reverend Bishop S.G. Sadananda, Bishop of South Kalamata Diocese, the chairman of this institution and the moderator's committee. I also welcome our Vice Chairman, Reverend H.S. Karunakara, the Treasurer of the Board of Management, Mr. Victor Daniel, the members of the Advisory Committee, and all other distinguished guests. Welcome to an interactive session with him, and I think with this, we leave the stage to Honorable Dr. Abdul Kalam. We request our Bishop, Right Reverend Sadananda, to kindly felicitate Dr. Kalam.
A great teacher I had. 19 1941, British India, okay? At the time, British were ruling us. Now, who is ruling? We are ruling ourselves, right? We are ruling ourselves. Good ruling you are doing. Now, this teacher, you should be lucky enough. You should be lucky enough to have great teachers, because they can give you game in life. They can, their life become medium. A great teacher, whatever he does in life, beauty of life, and his knowledge, we are all absorbing. So, my friends, I wish you all the best for the students of Cathedral School, Bangalore. Now, I would like to write Reverend Dr. J.S. Sadananda, Bishop of Southern Karnataka. I'm very happy to see them. And Isabella Simonji, Principal Cathedral High School. And she's the most powerful lady to manage all of you. Isn't that? What is it? Now, friends, I'm delighted to address and interact with the students of Cathedral School, Bangalore, which is over 150 years old. 146 years old, eh? Almost, eh? 146 years old. What does it mean? 146 years old. You know, Cathedral School, your school, is an earth, isn't it? It's an earth-based school, not moon-based or Mars-based. Now, earth follow rotating one axis. How much time it takes? Very good. This time, good answer. 24 hours. Now, earth follow orbits around? Earth orbits around? Our sun, isn't it? How much time it takes? About a year. That means, Cathedral School, Bangalore, which is the earth, it is orbited around the sun 146 times. You follow? 146 times. For example, so I congratulate the Cathedral School, Bangalore, for completing so many orbits and seeing many stars. And this school will create many stars in many fields. So I wish you all the best. When I think of this school, I am reminded of the unique action of that just now your principal said, then Pastor Reverend S.T. Pettigrew, to commence this school for the two orphan children at the request by their grandmaster, grandmother. Today I am happy to see that the school has graduated from orphanage to secondary school and subsequently to college, having strength of over 4,000 students. I congratulate the pioneers, both present and past, who have built a robust education framework in the Cathedral School at Bangalore. My greetings to all of you. I am sure, like Pastor Reverend S.T. Pettigrew, all of you will be the givers to the society. You must be the givers of society and make the nation smile. Will you? When I am here with all of you, I would like to share a few thoughts on the topic I am going to talk to you. I am born with wings. I am born with wings. That's the topic. It's okay. It's okay. Now, let us see. Every one of you who are assembled here, you can be a unique person. Right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I am going to tell you. Now you just look up. Look up. Don't look downstairs. Always look up. When you look up, what you see? You see the bulb. You see the light. Who do you remember? Thomas Alva Edison. And for his unique contribution toward the invention of electric bulb and electrical lighting system. And when you are, some of you are at hostel, some of you will be home, you are coming, every day you will hear the sound of the aircraft. Okay? When the aircraft fly, you will remember two fellows. Very good children, right brothers, you remember. And I don't know how many of you got mobile telephone, but anyway, I assume all of you have got a telephone. When the telephone bell rings, whom do you remember?
Alexander
Graham Bell, you remember. Very good children. Now, there was a great scientist in India who was traveling somewhere in the 1930s. He was traveling from London to Calcutta. When he reached Calcutta, one evening, by those days, no other transport stamp except ship for the ship for the foreign travels. So he saw the sun was shining, the sea was blue, horizon was blue, and sky was blue. He asked a question. He asked a question, why sky is blue? Why horizon, why the sea is blue when sun is shining? He got that. He asked that question. And that question led to a big scientific discovery. He got a Nobel Prize. Can you pick up? Can you pick up? Who? Very good. Sir C.V. Raman. For backscattering of light. That question because he asked. Okay? Because that question he asked, and he has to work for nearly 5 years. Why it so? That he established backscattering of light, and for that he was given the Nobel Prize. Now, there was a big mathematician in India, celebrated all over, number theory man. That number theory man, when he passed, when he passed 10 plus 2, then in those days, intermediate, when he examined, he passed everything, except mathematics. Okay? He failed every subject except mathematics. So mathematics, 100% he got, 100%. But other subjects completely failed. So, he has to discontinue. Those days as per the rule, British India, I don't know, Indian India also may do. So he was not, he cannot accept it for colleges. So that's the situation. But this man did not live there. His passion for mathematics, number theory. He worked very hard. He published a number of papers. It appeared in the Science Journal, Mathematics Journal. And then he wrote a Cambridge professor, Professor Hardy, Cambridge professor, had seen his thesis at his paper. And he invited him, and he became a great mathematician of the world, and he's a celebrated mathematician. Even the problems he has focused today, we are discovering, and discovering, and discovering. Such an app, can you think of? Do that great mathematician. Srinivasa Ramanujan. Now, you know, we have Sun, and it has got how many planets?
Eight
planets in the design very far. Eight planets. Now, these eight planets and all orbiting around the sun. Whereas sun orbits around what? What is the galaxy? Basically, the sun orbits around our galaxy. That takes 250 million years to an orbit. Imagine how many stars, billions and billions of stars are there. And it takes 250 million.